When you make sodium hypochlorite, you make roughly 95% sodium hypochlorite and maybe as much as 5% sodium hypochlorous acid. So a competitor to us, Myox, which is now owned by Denora, will say, oh, we're the only company that makes a mixed oxidant. Well, every sodium hypochlorite generator does that. Okay, it's just part of the process. However, if you want to make sodium hypochlorous acid, it's a very simple similar machine, salt and water, but you have to hold the process in a very tight pH range within 2/10 of a pH, and you end up making 95% sodium hypochlorous acid and less than 5% sodium hypochlorite. Both are disinfectants. What's the difference? First of all, sodium hypochlorous acid is heavily regulated by the FDA and the federal government all around the world. It has a very small shelf life, 30 days. Okay? Chlorine, 6 months. What's the difference though? Well, chlorine, you don't want to spray it in your eyes or spray it in your mouth, okay? Sodium hypochlorous acid, you can. They both kill germs. We do have that machine downstairs. And that would probably be more appropriate for spraying restaurants or even this room, especially during the COVID virus. So I'm trying to explain things in as simple a way as possible. Steve Carpenter and Amr Zaki, if you want to hear all the technical terms and all of the chemical symbols, you're free to talk with them. Any other questions? They're all good. Before we move on from this.
On the storm water, now that you have the right certification, do you compete with the AquaSwirl?
That sounds like a separator device. I'm not familiar with the AquaSwirl, but those cyclone devices are the same technologies that we used to use and Smith & Lovell still uses for grit removal in the headworks of sewage systems. The Biomicrobix version, by the way, for the grit removal in the headworks is the Mighty Vault. Very simple, very low cost way to settle out grit and trash and manage it from one vault, as opposed to an expensive cyclone that has to really be sized for a narrow flow range, or else the cyclone isn't strong enough and the grit doesn't drop out.